This is the Palmetto Ford Truck World Sports Desk. Come in. You'll get the best total deal on the new Ford F-150 and Super Duty.
It's so good to welcome the River Dogs back.
Oh boy, they're playing well, too. It's nice to see good baseball down at the Joe. Mm-hmm.
It really is. You know, we talk so much about how well they hit the ball in the last month or so. Sure. Not so much tonight, in the opener. The opener of two, by the way. The River Dogs bats went silent. They were also staring directly at the wrong side of history. Here's what happened. This was the completion of a suspended game back on June 12th. It started in the bottom of the second. Anderson Polino pitched six innings of no-hit ball for the Fireflies, striking out six. The River Dogs just couldn't break through. But then in the eighth against Zach Phillips coming up, Abizel Ramirez gets the only hit right there for Charleston. A single to left. The River Dogs, though, are shut out in game one. Your final 2-0. The last time the River Dogs were one hit was back in 2019. In game two, Charleston bounces back for a 5-4 win. The River Dogs are now 50-21 on the season. The Charleston Battery on the road Tuesday looking for a third straight win, facing Loudoun United away from home. Check out these highlights. This is some impressive stuff. The Battery strikes first. Watch this free kick that leads to a diving header right there by DZ Harmon. Nicely done. That was slick. And so is this. Claudio Repetto with the first of his two goals. Watch closely. Oh, it's the back heel. Come on now. Make it three. Look at it. He knows what he did. Make it three straight wins for the Battery. Your final is 5-3. Now here's one for you. South Carolina's Shane Beamer and Clemson's Dabo Swinney at the same event. It sounds like a possible cage match to me, but it wasn't. It was all good. It was for the Coaches for Charity event held in Greenville tonight. Big crowd on hand to see coaches from around the state who made an appearance. Plenty of memorabilia on display as well. And for Beamer and Sweeney, they're not rivals right now, just old friends catching up in person.
Obviously, always great to see Coach, somebody that I've had a lot of respect for a long time. It's been great to me since I became the head coach at Carolina. And like you said, it's good to finally catch up in person and not just on the phone.
I've known Shane forever, and we were great friends when he was at South Carolina the first time. I mean, he's one of the class guys in this business. He's always done things the right way.
All right, that is a quick glance at sports. Won't see those two gentlemen together again until the end of Thanksgiving week, right? I'm Mark Morgan. Final weather word is next.